A Pennsylvania high school senior can't wear an Army sash during graduation. Tony Kress has already signed her enlistment papers to join the Army with plans to leave for boot camp in August. The school apparently saying the sash didn't coincide with school colors, so it can't be worn. Tony Kress, the graduating senior, along with her father and military veteran Wayne Kress, join us now to discuss. Thank you both for joining us this morning. Thank you both for your service, by the way. Sir, you served in the Air Force, I believe. And Tony, you want to join the Army, and you will be joining the Army. What explanation were you given to start out for why you can't wear an Army sash with your graduation gown?
For starters, the first explanation I was given is that it didn't match the school colors.
Is that in the handbook? Because I think some have scoured your actual policies and procedures, and there's nothing in there that says that, you know, something doesn't match, you can't wear it.
Yeah, some people looked into it, and they actually figured out there's nothing in the handbook that says that I'm not allowed to wear it.
And so when it comes to graduation, I believe is on June 1st, are you going to wear it, or are you going to abide by school policy? What are you going to do there?
I'm going to abide by school policy. You know, like, people are, like, saying, like, I'm going to be, like, a rule breaker and stuff like that, but I have no intention of doing that at all. You know, if the school says I'm not allowed to wear it, I'm not going to wear it. You know, I'm not going to disrespect the school like that. But if I do have a chance, you know, off stage when I can wear it, I'm going to wear it.
You know, Wayne, as a father watching this, you raise a daughter who says, I want to raise my right hand and defend this country. I want to go to boot camp. I want to be a part of the military. How does it make you feel that a school won't allow her to recognize that?
I'm disappointed. She worked hard for this. You know, she went through the ROTC program through the school. You know, in today's world where, you know, we have kids out there eating Tide Pods, you know, she's willing to stand up, you know, and fight for her country. And, you know, both of my kids are actually in the Army, and I couldn't be more proud of both of them.
Wayne, still to you, your service, I mean, what as you raise young kids that want to join the military, how did you infuse them with the values that they needed to say, I want to be a part of it as well?
You just got to, you know, just start, you know, young. You got to instill with them, you know, discipline, integrity. And, you know, in the end, you know, both my children have come out to be, you know, excellent kids.
Tony, regardless of whether you get to wear it or not, and guess what? Our viewers are with you. They believe the school should make an exception for that. Are you looking forward to the opportunity to serve your country?
Oh, absolutely. I'm actually really stoked. I'm really stoked to, you know, to serve my country. It's been my dream since I was a kid.
I love it. Well, Tony, thank you very much. And Wayne, thank you for your service. Stoked is a good way to put it. We'll take that. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Congrats on your graduation.